click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the emulsion as well as we have also discussed about that how the emulsion is being prepared by using the emulsifier or emulsifying agent. So now we are talking about now de-emulsification. So what is de-emulsification and how that can be done? Let us talk about it. So talking about de-emulsification, let us understand the definition of it, and the definition is So the process of separation of liquid dispersed phase, that is the liquid dispersed phase. The process of separation of liquid dispersed phase with that of the dispersed medium is known as de-emulsification. So we know that as in emulsion, the dispersed phase and the dispersed medium, they are in contact with each other through and they form that is a stable that is a solution, and that is because of the emulsifying agent or the emulsifier. So now the thing that we have to do is we have to separate this two, that is the dispersed phase along with that of the dispersed medium. So this kind of separation is basically known as de-emulsification. So what are the different kind of methods that we could do for de-emulsification? Let us talk about that also. So talking about the first method, that is by heating, freezing and centrifuging, we can do the de-emulsification. So for example, if I am talking about heating, so whenever we heat a particular that is emulsion, then there is a separation of two layers where we could find that the emulsion has become will now become unstable, and that would be like a lipophobic sole. So in this case, we see the dispersed phase and the dispersed medium, the both will get separated. And by freezing also, as we have discussed earlier also, that is while freezing, we see what happens is the dispersed medium gets separates from that of that is the dispersed phase, and then basically the coagulation takes place over there. So here also in the same thing that we could do the de-emulsification. And talking about the centrifuging, as you know that centrifuging is the method where we could separate the colloidal particles, or we could deposit the largest particles in one side, and the particles which are of lower mass, they that could be separated very easily. So therefore this method can be also be applicable so as to perform the de-emulsification process. So this is the first method that I was talking about, and now let us talk about the second method. So the second method is by addition of excess electrolytes. Yes, by addition of excess electrolyte, we can also do the de-emulsification, where we could find that the colloidal particles, or where see that the dispersed phase, that could be easily separated from that of the dispersed medium, and that is what the de-emulsification is, and this can be done in this method. And talking about the last one, that is. So the next point is by addition of acid. So in the previous lecture we have got to know that is the soap, which is acting like an emulsifying agent, or which is acting like an emulsifier that stabilizes the emulsion. But meanwhile, when we are adding acid to it, and we know that soap is basically an ester of basically the fatty acid. So whenever an acid is being added in the soap, so now the hydrolysis will take place, and in that case the fatty acid will be produced. So now that fatty acid will not be a good emulsifying agent compared to that of the soap. So here how we can de-emulsify the emulsion, and there how we can get two layers, that is one will be the layer of the dispersed medium, while the other one will be the layer of the dispersed phase. So this is how we can separate the two, that is the two components. So this is what the de-emulsification is. So that is it, that is what I want to talk about. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope you will share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.